One of the, most of you know me, those of you who do not know me, I'm Harnish Raj, a cycling enthusiast. I'm here to celebrate our dear Joseph's achievements in cycling, and that is why we are all here. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all on this occasion. We are seeing a small list which says 50,000 kilometers in 3 years and 25,000 kilometers in the year 2021. And we are still in October 2021, 2 more months to go. And Violet Man says, enough. Already, here in this, that was missed out, and I wish to proudly announce this. So quickly, we will come to the Mr. Hariram Shankar on the task, sir. He is the Deputy Commissioner of Police. We have this, the captain of cycling, as we all know him, our own Anil Sheth from Mangalore Cycling Club. I again wish to request Joseph sir to please escort him on the dais. Sir, we also have with us Mr. Sarvesh, who is the president of BR Cycling Club. I wish to request Joseph sir to please escort him also on the dais. And we have this thought, it is his privilege to be a part of this small function, and he flew all the way from Chennai, our beloved coach Mr. Gresham. Sir, please come on stage. Mr. Joseph. Yes, and of course, the man be replying towards my first sentence. A round of applause, please. Thank you. So, our chief guest for today is Mr. Hariram Shankar, Deputy Commissioner of Police, Law and Order. I was actually reading his profile. Very, very.
The ever increasing traffic, bad road conditions, safety aspects kept him away from getting onto the pedals. However, in 2018, a journalist friend of him who was doing his morning rides rekindled his passion for cycling, and without thinking twice, Joseph sir sold his motorbike and went on to purchase his first road bike from Track and Trail. Like every new riders, initially he could barely ride 10 to 15 kilometers. However, his passionate towards cycling, he started riding cycling continuously and lost his weight from 95 kgs to 65 kgs, and a massive improvement in his cycling techniques and his abilities. Later, he joined various cycling clubs around Mangalore, notably Mangalore Cycling Club, Mangalore Bicycling Club, and recently VR Cycling Mangalore, and he started doing club rides, events and various races. His first major 100 km ride was a ride to Udupi and back, followed by a grueling 260 km ride to Sakleshpur, which he did secretly without telling his wife Violet. After this, there were no looking back for him, and he started riding his morning rides or evening rides or afternoon rides continuously. And since that period, Joseph sir has walked, as you can see, 50,000 kilometers in the last 3 years, out of which 25,000 in the last 1 year itself. He has completed 100 rides in 100 consecutive days. A hat-trick win of Trek India Challenge, Trek India Challenge is quite unique, where cyclists from across India take part in this, and it is really commendable to see Joseph sir winning this challenge consecutively for 3 years. Well, every rider's bucket list is incomplete unless he is having a small accident in his career. And so too was Joseph sir. While during one of his morning rides, he had a small fall. Though for the fall was small, he had severe injuries. He had his surgeries done to fix the collarbone and his punctured leg, punctured lungs. And to everyone's surprise, because of his fitness, he was back on the road again riding in 3 months. Joseph sir says all these achievements were not possible without the support and encouragement of his family and his beloved wife Violet, who has tolerated and supported him all through his day in and day out. Joseph sir's message to the youth is, if you want to remain healthy, if you want to save the environment, take up cycling and ride every day for at least 15 to 20 kilometers. Commute by cycle to your college or schools, and he has been a green ambassador for Mangalore City until today. For me personally, in fact, Joseph sir, I call him as a man of the moment, and I usually, whenever I meet him, I call him as the Iron Man of cycling, because he has been inspirational. At the age of 60 plus, he has been riding consistently, he has been riding continuously, and he has been a role model, not only for the kids, even for us. And once again, we are happy to be part of this celebration, sir. Thank you.
I still don't know what is underneath, because our interactions have been very less. But when I look at the list of achievements that he has made, 50,000 kilometers in 3 years is like circling the globe once and then another 10,000 more kilometers, because the circumference of the globe is 40,000 kilometers. So he's literally done one full round of the earth and then gone another 10,000 kilometers ahead in the last 3 years. Which is a very, very commendable achievement. I think we should all give one round of applause for him for that. And as the introduction, we heard a lot of description about his achievements and how Madam also had a very strong role in it. I actually suspect that she doesn't want him at home much. So she keeps on encouraging him to go cycle, go cycle. And then side by side, he had his own piece of mind and she had her own piece of mind. This is a key to a successful marriage, I think. So get your husband a cycle. That would be the best thing. Anyway, ma'am has supported and appreciated his achievement at every point of time. She keeps on messaging me about his achievements, about her family and other things, but especially about him, in fact. So it's a great thing that, you know, they are both enjoying and that he is able to achieve whatever he wants to achieve in his own career. And despite having a very serious accident, in 3 months coming back to the same field, I'm pretty sure we will still have those fears. Usually push any person backward, right? It's okay now that I'm around 60, 60, 60. My dad is almost the same age. He also has a beard. But he doesn't like it. Yeah. So, overall, I'm very happy to come here to him being called as a guest for this program. And, so, you know, like, civil service was never my preferred career option till the end of it. But it is never monotonous, never repetitive, and never makes you feel that you are doing an exercise for the sake of doing an exercise. It is always an enjoyable activity, even for others who are not into regular cycling also. So, yeah, I am happy to have come here next day. I wish him and madam all the best of health, and let him stay more and more peace. Thank you.
One needs to take into consideration that this gentleman is 62. I think from the
62.
So I've had injuries while I cycled.
At 40, I recovered in a day, 2 days. At 50, it took me 6 months. And this man breaks his shoulder, punctures his lungs, and he's on a cycle in 1.5 hours. I mean, I don't need to say anything. It needs for all of you to understand what good health means. I haven't met Joseph before. This is my first time this morning that I met him. But I'm on the group with the WERC. And I've been following his post, and I'm usually very slow to respond, but the moment I knew that they were facilitating him, I said this man needs to be recognized. It's my honor to be here. Absolute honor. Taking a little bit of note from your speech, sir. Like you rightly pointed out, cycling is a very. I'm not going to talk any further because I think to take the honor away from Joe. So, but since you mentioned something about cycling and the academy, I've been talking to Mr. Sailendra Babu from Chennai, who's the current DGP. He's a very avid cyclist and a runner. And we are planning to form a Tamil Nadu police cycling team, which will represent Tamil Nadu as a cycling team at the national. And I would humbly request you to consider thinking of starting a cycling team. Any formation thoughts, I'm happy to come down and help you. But do that, because I think it's a very good activity for the police itself. You know, because by being on the cycle, there's a better opportunity for them to interact with people on a more humane scale. And it also, you know, it gives them a better feeling, both as a sports activity and both on the human side. So I suggest that. Having said that, I don't want to take any more time on the thing, and I would like to have Mr. Joseph
celebrate his achievements with all of you all, and thank you very much.
And the example is Joseph sir. Cycling helped me a lot. It reduced my blood pressure, and very few people used to ride in Mangalore. Whenever local used to see, they used to speak in English. They thought we are from some different country. But now there are more number of cyclists, more than 1,500 cyclists. So now they talk in the local languages, sir. Joseph sir is a dedicated cyclist. He rides regularly in the morning. I was riding with him when he did his 100 kilometers. So actually it is not 100. Every day he used to do more than 100. Some day he used to do 200 also. Then I said, sir, 200 means it is 200. So he used to say, no, it is only 100. So you have to put it. By the time we ended his 10,000, like the 100 days challenge, it was more than 12,000 to 30,000 kilometers. So, and I ride regularly with him. Even today morning I went around 70 kilometers with him. The problem is that he rides faster than it is very difficult. So what I told today morning is, sir, you don't stop, go ahead and stop. Instead of that, you go around one more round and come behind us so that we can match our speed. So, and I wish Joseph sir a good health, so he completes 1,00,000 kilometers as early as possible. And I request all cyclists to ride regularly, riding a cycle won't reduce their weight, but riding it regularly will reduce it, will benefit everybody. Thank you.
Everything. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming. And we have President, we are cycling, Sarvesh sir, who has been here. I think when Violet ma'am spoke to him, he was like, I will give the introduction speech of Joseph sir, and probably Violet madam asked him then what about the rest. Adella Ambish Martha, when you mentioned madam. And that is why I am here on stage with this mic. So thank you so much sir, and thank you each and every one of you, your family, like how most of them on the stage mentioned in their respective speeches, that if you have the backup and support from your, so thank you one and all for coming to this small event and helping Joseph sir and Violet ma'am to celebrate his achievements in cycling. Thank you one and all. Dinner is ready. And
seasons come and go like thoughts of you.